put on the whole armor of God. Now, this phrase, full armor, is sometimes translated panoply, complete outfit of armor. And the only other time it's used in the New Testament, it's describing how the Lord has taken away the armor of Satan. He said, when they accused him of being in league with Beelzebub, the prince of demons, and that's how he was doing his mighty work. Well, the Lord Jesus said, a house divided against itself cannot stand. Let me tell you how it really happened, he said. While a strong man's arm keeps his palace, his goods are in peace. That's the devil. And the world is at peace today. It's not the peace of God. It's a false peace. It's a fool's paradise, asleep on the very brink of hell, one heartbeat from hell, and they're at peace. These things don't bother them. But when a stronger than he comes, that's the Lord Jesus, he takes away all his armor, that's the same word, takes away all his armor in which he trusts and spoils his goods. That's what the Lord Jesus has done. He's not only given us armor, he's taken away the devil's armor. It's really a lopsided battle if the truth were known. The sword of the Spirit, the Word of God. Now, the sword is not defensive. You can't stop darts with the sword very well. The sword is aggressive. And the purpose is, this is the Word of God in action. This is spoken. This isn't the Word of God in the scabbard, walking around saying, I got a bigger scabbard than you do. Well, that's not the point, is it? Some have big fancy scabbards, little rubber swords that wouldn't do any damage to anybody. It's none of this, there's a verse around here somewhere sort of like this. No, it's, thus saith the Lord. Our society needs to hear the Word of God. You think they know it? They don't know it. I speak in high schools. And you assume that all these high school kids in the secular world, they're a bunch of rebels against God. I speak to them, they come up to me and say, I never heard that before. Never heard that. I've been to church since I was in diapers, and I never knew that. I feel betrayed. I've gone to church for years. They never told me that. I mean, lots of them. We need to be aggressive to speak a word for God. People say, nice day, isn't it? Yeah, yeah, this is the day the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Give it to them. You got the book. Use it. The effectiveness of the Word of God, it gets to the heart. And like the story of the big fat King Eglon, when they got the sword in, they couldn't get it out. I want to tell you that when you use the Word of God, it gets in and people can't get it out. It has sticking power. We need to use the Word of God, to use it effectively. Learn to use the sword before the enemy shows up. God's equipped us. We have all that we need to stand against the enemy, having done all, to stand.